I got a bone up here. I don't want you monkey mouth motherfucker sitting in my throne again. Hello guys, I think Hercules here. Welcome back to the channel. And I'm actually have something very exciting I want to talk to you guys about today. Let's just start off with this. I've been very happy that I do no script clips lately, but this one was actually made me upset that I didn't do no script clip to the point I wrote bullet notes. Listen to me, hip hop is all but been abolished. We already had so much shit going on, from the motherfucking, no, excuse my friend, like the sexy red kind of shit going on, to like motherfuckers just like trying to say like, I just do this rap shit on the side. Motherfuckers not doing it for artistic ability. Motherfuckers flooding albums just to like produce streams. And it was so much stuff going on. But you did this? You did this? And it's so much shit I actually want to say. One, all right, you know what? Fuck this shit. Fuck all that. You said this shit was not sitting right with your spirit. Well, it wasn't sitting right with your spirit, nigga. It's the fact that you put out a bum-ass diss track and you were scared. You was like, oh my fucking God, this nigga is literally about to assassinate me. And I have to get in front. I have to preemptively apologize. I have to apologize. You said this for 3 years straight. You fucking said you were the best. You called yourself Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali is not standing in front of a ring and saying, chin check me, bro. Throw your best shot. What? And I'm talking not Cassius Clay, Muhammad Ali. Post-spiritual acceptance. Post-spiritual gainance. What the fuck are you talking about? You're a liar. You're being a fucking... That's what you... You said that was the one of the worst things you ever did. No, what you just... The most goofy shit you ever did was just then. Just right fucking here and now. Oh my God. I've never been this loud. I've never been this mad. Please, hold on. Let me actually stop this clip and see how loud I sound and see if I can keep talking, because I am this fucking mad. You once said, this cannot be from the nigga that said he let Nas down.
Fuck Jay-Z.
What's up, niggas?
Yo, hold on, y'all. I live in the Matrix. This shit is the Matrix. It is no way you made a song called Let Nas Down and then you just Oh, you did not just apologize. Please tell me you didn't just do that. You made this. Freddy Krueger's in the building.
Welcome to your nightmare, bitch.
Oh my God, you act like Kendrick Lamar was God. He was about to smite you. He was literally about to hit your ass with a bolt of electricity, a jolt of that shit that you just could not consume. What is wrong with you? Why did you just do that? It was no reason. No one was about to die. No one in Dreamville was going to die. No one in TDE was going to die. What the fuck are you talking about? You ain't sleep right for 2 days.
I'm Scary Terry. You can run, but you can't hide, bitch.
Is this nigga Freddy Krueger? Is he Candyman? You say fucking Kung Fu Kenny, Kung Fu Kenny, Kung Fu Kenny, and he come from behind and slit your fucking throat east to the fucking west where he goes from?
Biggie Smalls. Biggie Smalls. Biggie Smalls.
What the fuck is this?
What are you doing? Why did you just apologize as a hip-hop purist on stage mid-beef? I don't give a fuck about what you're talking about, because I know spiritual, healthy, healing-ass niggas that wouldn't have done what you just did. I mean, from a Lupe Fiasco to a fucking Royce da 5'9", to a motherfucking Kendrick Lamar himself who was healed and at peace and all this shit you trying to... He did this after Mr. Moreau and the Big Steppers. He's healed, nigga, and he said, fuck you. And you went, yeah, you right. It's fuck me. Throw another shot if you will. What? What? You done went from I let Nas down to let y'all down. You let hip-hop down with that one, bro. I'm be real. You let hip-hop. Hip-hop. I ain't say rap, bro. You let hip-hop. Niggas that was waiting for bars to make a return. This was the chance, bro. You dropped the ball on everything. All Kendrick Lamar did was give you a chin check and don't sit right. And you're I guarantee you, if your fucking diss was good and niggas loved that shit and was saying, oh my fucking God, call that nigga. You would have been like, yeah, it would have sat right with your spirit. But it ain't sit right with your spirit. You gone on this bitch and you lied. You lied on the fucking track. And that's what don't sit right with your spirit. Why didn't you say that? Why didn't you say, yo, I ain't gonna lie, my shit was kind of... Why'd you say anything? And now, you have now, by doing what you did, you have cemented, quicksand yourself right into third place, now into the end of my fucking eyeball sockets closed. And honestly, more than likely, almost until the end of all of our eyeball sockets closed. We don't care about your music. Bro, there is not a... Listen, we go by this. You have to be battle tested. You have to be. No matter how you slice that fucking pie, you have to be battle tested. There is not a top five in anyone's category. If anyone did a top five, I guarantee you, it might be one person that ain't battle tested. But more than likely, all five of them niggas gonna be battle tested. What's wrong with you, nigga? Come on. You ain't ready for battle? And you black? Where's your tribal essence? Where's your spiritual warrior? What are you actually doing? And like, you MLK ass nigga. And even MLK is battle tested. You less battle tested than Martin Luther King, the most peaceful human being I know. You're pathetic. Sorry, I don't give a fuck. Your music is awesome. You're a lyrical, but you are pathetic. I didn't want to see two black men beating and blunting and gudgeoning themselves. I wanted to see two men exercise their brain and show me the most absolute capacitance that it has. And you avoided that. You made me think you not real smart like. You made me think, bro, I ain't gonna lie, it was always a question of who I should follow. And it's always been this way. Whether it's been the Martin Luther King or the Malcolm X, you know, the peaceful or the radical. You just showed me I can't follow no peaceful nigga at all. Because a peaceful nigga going, apologize, forgive, and we over here getting slayed, and you apologizing. Meanwhile, Kendrick going to fight. He going to fucking fight. Why you ain't fucking fight? I'm so confused. I am bewildered. Kendrick is as peaceful as you, as relaxing as you, as conscious as you. He wasn't about to beat your ass up in fucking North Carolina. Man, I ain't gonna lie. You lost a fan, bro. You lost a fan straight up, nigga. I am not a fan of you anymore behind this. I'm simply not a fan of you anymore. I can't be. Because I think about the background and shit. Like, I can't. Bro, you, come on, bro. You got the ducats, bro. You supposed to be a leader. Ain't no leader supposed to bend and fold and break his back and apologize. And I'm sorry, I've been probably fucking loud as shit, but I'm agitated and I'm aggravated. But why behind a hip-hop purist stepping on fucking stage and apologizing like a little, ooh, I want to say the word. I'm not. You know what I want to say. The person that most people consider the best rapper of all time made songs like Dear Mama, made songs like Changes, made songs like Staring Through My Rearview. Tupac, of course, is what we talking about. One of the people we look at is like, yo, that's the person you kind of want to be if you want to be the best rapper. He is the equivalent of the Michael Jordan of hip-hop. Tupac, yo, I can't imagine Tupac getting on stage and saying, yo, that shit I said to Biggie don't sit right with my spirit. And Tupac didn't die behind the Biggie beef. Tupac died behind literal blood and Crip shit. So if you want to go, well, Tupac would be alive if he did apologize. No, it had nothing to do with that. Know the facts. I know the facts. Tupac or Biggie Smalls were not ever going to kill each other. To the point that Tupac actually has a clip of when he pulls up to Biggie. And he said, bro, this shit is just entertainment, bro. You see how much money we're getting? We are getting rich as fuck. All my nigga look rich as fuck type shit. Like, no one was gonna die. That was not Tupac's expectance or Biggie's expectance, you know? So, like, when you go to fucking Ice Cube, another real fucking conscious rapper knows what's going on in the community. Ice Cube ain't about to step on that stage and apologize, bro. He just not. Yo, I can't even see, like, Andre 3000, the nigga who walks around and plays the flute. I can't see Andre 3000 doing that. Andre 3000 gonna burn your ass up and let you know you ain't got it like I got it, nigga. Why you ain't go? You ain't like I'm thinking of like the most. I'm not even going to hood niggas, if you see. Because the hood niggas is always going to like, hold on, nigga, I'm the big stepper. I'm telling you about real conscious rappers that went, oh, hold on, you testing my lyrical ability? Oh, let me check you real fast. Let me let you know where you got that. Lupe Fiasco, we'll check your ass real fast. Motherfucking Common, we'll check your ass real fast. Even our sweetheart Drake, we'll check your ass real fast. And you apologize? Hold on, guys. This is the point where I just want to play this apology. Full and forth through, and I will talk some more afterwards.
It's one part of that shit that make me feel like, man, that's the lamest shit I ever did in my fucking life, right? And I know this is not what a lot of people want to hear. I know I can hear my niggas up there right now like, nah, nah, don't do that. But I got to keep it 100 with y'all, right? I damn near had a relapse, right? Because y'all heard some shit that happened two, three weeks ago, however long it was. Y'all heard that bazooka that was dropped on the motherfucking game, right? So all of this time of me moving on my own accord, for the first time I was tested. Why am I tested? Because I got the world and I got my niggas like, what you gonna do, Cole? My niggas like, bit boy, I must have had 1,000 missed calls. Oh my fucking God. Text flooded. I couldn't even answer my shit. Nigga, it's wartime. Boom, boom, right? Niggas want to see blood. And I was conflicted because, one, I know my heart, you know what I mean? And like, I know how I feel about my peers, these two niggas that I just been blessed to even stand beside in this game, let alone chase their greatness, right? So I felt conflicted because I'm like, bro, I know I don't really feel no way, but the world want to see blood. I don't know if y'all can feel that, but the world want to see blood. So I say all of that to say, in my spirit of trying to like get this music out, I ain't gonna lie to y'all, I moved in a way that I feel spiritually feel bad on me. Like I try to like jab my nigga back and I try to keep it friendly. But at the end of the day, when I listen to it and when it comes out and I see the talk, that shit don't sit right with my spirit. That shit make me feel, that shit disrupts my fucking peace. So what I wanna say right here tonight is in the midst of me doing that and in that shit, trying to find a little angle and downplay this nigga's fucking catalog and his greatness. I want to say right now tonight, how many people think Kendrick Lamar is one of the greatest motherfuckers to ever touch a fucking microphone? Dreamville, y'all love Kendrick Lamar, correct? As do I. So I just want to come up here and be like, publicly be like, bruh, that was the lamest, like, goofiest shit. And I say all that to say, it made me feel like 10 years ago when I was moving incorrectly. And I pray that God align me back up on my purpose and on my path. You know what I mean? I pray that my nigga really didn't feel no way. And if he did, my nigga, I got my chin out. Take your best shot. I'm gonna take that shit on the chin, boy. Do what you do. You know what I mean? Like, all good. Like, it's love. And I pray that, you know, I pray that y'all are like, forgive a nigga for like the misstep and then I can get back to my true path. Cause I ain't gonna lie to y'all, the past 2 days felt terrible. Like, it let me know how good I've been sleeping for the past 10 years.
You said you had been moving on your own accord, but your own accord had included you calling yourself the greatest, the greatest, the greatest. And when you say that you are the greatest, then the actual other greatest will come and see if you actually are one of the greatest. Because you can never actually be just the greatest, but you can be considered a GOAT, a greatest of all time. And all that happened was a greatest of all time said, okay, it's time to see if this greatest of all time is equivalent to me. This nigga had the audacity to say, why am I being tested? Why don't you reference tracks like First Person Shooter and all the times you've been calling yourself the GOAT, the greatest, the best? Who else thinks they're the GOAT, the greatest, the best? Kendrick Lamar. Who else is still currently alive and active in the rap game? Kendrick Lamar. Don't ask stuff that you know the answers to. That's bullshit. And you're not being 100 with us. That's not being 100 when I just know the answers just hearing your questions. And you're smart enough to know the answers to these questions before you even stepped on stage. You didn't just come out here like, oh my God, why am I blindsided? Why are you acting like that? Why, oh, I, you know, bro, come on, man. Stop being a bitch. He then goes, niggas want to see blood. My people want to see blood. No, we don't. You're a liar. And don't put that on us. We want to see mental aptitude. We want to see two men go about it in a lyrical bout of strength. That's all. Nah, you're not about to sit here and say we wanted to see y'all kill each other. Nah, bitch, you're a fucking liar. And don't put that on me. And don't put that on us. We ain't want that shit. That's why we liked it, you fucking lying ass bitch. That's some lying ass bitch. Don't go on that. People wanted to see blood. They wanted to see. Nah, nigga. We want to see how fucking intelligent you were on the fucking microphone versus another nigga who was smart as fuck on the microphone. You lie. That's some. Ooh, that's the part that get me the most mad. Cause you putting your own acclamations onto us. We ain't want to see that shit, you bitch. We want to see how fucking smart you were versus Kendrick Lamar. And you avoided it. Admit it. Admit what the fucking truth is.
Yo, if it was friendly, why did you apologize? And honestly, Kendrick was not friendly with what he said. He hit your ass with a chidori, the lightning spark shit. It hit you. It was internal organs. He was going for internal organs. The same way he did it fucking 10 years ago with Control. He went for your internal organs.
You know what time it is. And that goes for Jermaine Cole, Big Crit, Wale, Pusha T, Meek Mills, A$AP Rocky.
Called you Jermaine Cole. He referenced you government first and foremost. Nigga, you were first and foremost. He always been letting you know, I will crush your fucking neck, Naruto. And all you've been doing is being Naruto. You're my best friend. You're my nigga. I love you so much. What are you doing, bro? And I'm getting sick of it. Like, you disappointed me, bro. I ain't about to sit here and fucking overtalk y'all, man. He killed hip-hop with that one. Straight up, he killed hip-hop with that one. I don't want to hear no more about no fucking, don't show me no artists, don't show me shit. Because if a nigga like him doing something like this, and then you already got all these other people doing shit like that, man, this shit is deceased. 6 feet deep. Go ahead, like, and share, and subscribe, because I never been a creep. I think I'm Hercules out this bitch. Beep, beep, I'm in the Jeep.
Do it!
I'm glad you were here today.
Talk all my fear to my NATO arachnids. Bioshock shit, I'm strapped with plasmids. Mega bust up when I'm snapping like a spastic square. What happened? I'm on a tear when I spit. I be everywhere like I'm Book of the Whip.
My final thoughts and extra thoughts of this, guys. Post-editing, this is before I extract the video finally. That was very disappointing. That was a poor display of sportsmanship. It's the equivalent of like a basketball player not being competitive in the sport. It's like that nigga who was like trying to miss three-pointers on purpose because of his betting odds. It's like, it was very disappointing to see. And honestly, man, I'm the last nigga that wanted to see niggas die, but I did want to see people go about it in a lyrical bout. And everything I said is really, really true. This wasn't no joke. Like, you made me think I can't trust that peaceful guy because you're going to apologize in the time where we need you to actually fight. We need you like to be upstanding and more powerful. You seem like you lack power. I hope that your spiritual journey was worth what you just exchanged for it. I don't think what you said was actually all the way true. And I have a high belief that if your diss record would have hit very hard, you would have been very satisfied with the end result. I think that you made Kendrick Lamar like the boogeyman of hip hop. You ruined Drake's chance, really. So the whole thing is now lack of competitive because you made it look like he was so scary that I don't know. You just fucked up the whole optics of the beef. And the beef was all lyrical, spiritual, it was all words. So I don't know. I don't know, Jermaine. I would find another hobby if this part not in you. You opened up. I feel like if it was someone else, you would have. I don't know, like, what was it? Is it Kendrick that make you feel weird? Like, what kind of made you feel the way you felt? That's all I got for today, guys. Share it to your friends. I've been Hercules. Y'all been beautiful. I'm out.